Hello there. How's you doing today? I hope you're good. As for me, not so much. I'm just gonna paint as I talk. No, I'm going through some spiritual woefare. I mean, freaking hardcore. You know, I love it though. The Bible. I love the Bible because, man. You know, sometimes we're just not walking on the mountaintops. And, you know, when you're at a mountain, when you literally go to a mountain, you can see everything. Like, I feel like that when I, there's times in my walk with Christ where I feel like I'm on a mountain, like spiritually, like God, you know. He says, there's a scripture that says he shows us what he does. I think it's in John chapter 15. Friend, because we're his friend. And isn't that beautiful? We're God's friend. Wow. So, you know, he'll show me what he's doing in the spirit. And like, I'm hooked up with the Lord, you know, and I'm all about the Lord's business and his work and, you know, kingdom work, having kingdom mindset, right? I'm thinking about saving souls and touching people's heart and drawing them to him and helping them feel his love and all that stuff, right? That we do for Jesus while we're here. And it's like, I have strong discernment. At least I think I do. And maybe I don't as much as I think I do, but you know, like things are nice, and it's like you can see what God is doing in the spirit, and it's beautiful and fun and full joy. You know, things seem to be clear, and you know the Lord will be talking to you, which is wonderful. And you'll feel his love and his presence. Those are mountaintops. But y'all, over and over again, I think until the day we die, we be going through them valleys too. And I'm in a valley. Oh man, I'm in a valley. But I was thinking about coming on here to talk about these fiery darts. I've been thinking about the fiery darts in Ephesians. It talks about Ephesians chapter 6. You should go read it. It says that there's fiery darts of the enemy. And those fiery darts, you know what they are? They're like lies, I think. What the fiery darts are is those lies the devil lodges at our mind to and then those lies actually have a huge effect on our emotions. And you know, the devil, he wants to kill, steal, and destroy. So you know, like if you're not if you have not put on your armor and you don't got that word going into you, I mean all the time, because like we forget things. And if you're not into worship music, those lies from the devil that are like you don't even realize, it's an invisible thing that's happening against your mind. And when those lies come in and you believe them over God's word, then you go down, you sink, and you don't do so well. And they make you feel miserable and darkness. And it does not good. It is not good. It not feel good. No, it does not feel good at all. So we have to be in getting the word in us, whether listening to it or reading it, or and also worship music. It will help you. These lies, you know, the devil lodges at our minds. They're invisible. But very real. These fiery darts, man. Oh my gosh. I feel like I'm going through it right now. You know, I'm getting these thoughts like, God doesn't love me. God has forsaken me, because I can't feel the presence of God right now. I feel joy at times, but a lot of downness. And I thank God for the joy, because last night I was screaming and crying, you know. But I feel a little bit joyful today. God gave me strength. I prayed to God for strength. But like, so you know, like these thoughts are and feelings are coming at me like God doesn't love me, like condemnation big time, and it's from the devil. And for nothing, I've done nothing wrong, but I feel condemnation. So it's crazy. It's the devil. But yeah, like, man, I feel like, you know, where is God? I can't hear him. He's not talking to me. I know he's telling me get in the word. He wants me to have the word in him. Me more, he really talks to me through the scriptures. When I really have the word in my mind, the Holy Spirit will bring up scriptures and reveal them deeper to me. And it is like the most satisfying thing to think about the word of God. When the Holy Spirit reveals, gives you deeper revelation on scriptures and stuff and brings it up during your everyday life, it's just so amazing. But yeah, I know he's telling me to get in the word. Other than that, I'm not really like hearing the Lord. And I know it's pruning season. You know, Ephesians talks about he prunes us. He's like a gardener. So we have to go through a pruning season in the spirit sometimes. And you know, he wants to conform us to the image of Christ. So we go through these valleys, and he's, you know, taking things off that we didn't really realize that were there that needed corrected or, you know, removed, and bring us into repentance in areas. That's where I feel like I'm at right now. This is like a pruning season and spiritual warfare, and it sucks, but Christ is in it with me, and he's my strength, and he's your strength and your warfare. And you know, we just have to stand on the word. And as you're going through your warfare, you gotta really be in the word. I just want to encourage you in this video, listen to the word of God. If you can't read it, that's okay. You can listen to it. To listen to the word of God and listen to worship music and sing it when you can, because when you sing it, it's a way of drawing close to God and entering into his presence. But sometimes the warfare is so heavy, it's hard to sing. If you can't sing, you should get some flags. You could be singing to God through your movement, listening to worship music, and it helps. Let me tell you, I was under warfare today, and then my daughter called. We weren't supposed to see her today, but we got to see her, and she was coming with her friend, and they're very much in the darkness and need prayer and love. Please pray for them. And I was like, oh my gosh, Lord, how am I going to do this? Give me strength, because I feel like I'm being attacked so bad, right? Like, I do not feel happy in my soul. I don't feel like I'm on the mountaintop. I don't feel like I have physical strength, let alone mental strength. I'm like, God, help me. And he is so good. He did. I had my flags, and one of the weapons, you know, the Bible says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God. It's the pulling down of strongholds. So, in a warfare, if you've got a spiritual warfare, if you got some swing flags, Take them babies with you. Whip them out. Don't even care about the people around you. Play you some K-Love on your phone. And you be doing them flags as you walk around. Especially if you're at a mall or a Costco, you know, somewhere a lot of space. You just be you. Don't even care about other people's judgment. Maybe they'll hear the song and come to Christ. Who cares what they think? Freaking whip them flags out and dance around like nobody's there. And just think about Jesus. And it will uplift your mood. That's what I did today. It was very uplifting. I'm very grateful to God for it. And I hope they heard that worship music and come to know Jesus. People's hearts are so hard. It's so hard to win souls for Christ right now. But warfare is no joke. Spiritual warfare, no joke. So get you that Bible playing, New Testament or Old Testament, and listen to some worship music. And sing and dance. It'll help you through it. Yep. But pray for me, because this is a really tough season. Like, I can't even tell you what I'm going through in my soul. I'm like, God, where are you? But I know he's here, and I'm standing on the word. Be encouraged in your warfare. It won't last forever. Listen to worship. Listen to the Bible, because without it, you are going to be sinking. You're not going to feel good, and you're going to stay miserable until you get the truth. You know what? The word of God, it says, the truth shall set you free. And there's a scripture that says, the word is like a hammer that breaks the rock. Oh my goodness, I got to do a painting on that. So it's going to break the hardness and the lies and the hard-heartedness off of you, and the chains will break. You know, Paul and I think Silas were singing in jail, and the chains broke off of them. So singing, there's some power in worship. Power in worship, yo. You can enter into his presence. Psalms 100 verse 2 says, serve the Lord with gladness, enter into his presence with singing. So sing. And for y'all who are on the mountaintops right now, and you're going through a really clear season in your soul with God, that's wonderful. While you're there, could you pray for me? Because I'm having a hard time praying right now. Except for the little prayers like, help me. I can't do this anymore, Lord. Please help me. So y'all who are flying on the mountaintop with the Lord right now, pray for those who are not. And for those of y'all in the valley, be encouraged. Listen to worship. Listen to the Bible. Keep seeking the presence of God, which is more satisfying than sin. God bless you. Bye-bye. Share this video if it helped you.